I think the most important thing is that the student gets the fundamentals down, because that's the grounding and the foundation to everything creative. What happens is once the students are understood the fundamentals, the perspective, the color theory, the creative juices flow more freely, and the student can put his ideas down more in a more solid, fundamental way. Once the student is done with the fundamentals, he actually gets into more advanced production techniques. So we go through, you know, processes where he's learning matte painting, he's learning design. So I think the focus shifts from just learning from fundamentals to actually understanding aesthetics and design, where design plays a key role in production. Because what happens is you actually have to come up with ideas and design to be put into a game or a movie. So when the student is developing a portfolio, we kind of break it down into projects. So that actually shows the whole IP creation process from the start, where you do thumbnails and you do ideas and ideations, and then, you know, you keep refining it into a more awesome, a more fun product. So when the student is working on his portfolio, he needs to understand that he's going to be working in the industry really soon. So he needs to mirror his portfolio to the needs of the industry. One example of the portfolio would be, you know, taking a storybook idea or a game idea and kind of revamping it and, you know, re-energizing it. So we could take, you know, a storybook like, say, The Magical Faraway Tree. Or we could take a game like, you know, the 80s games like Prince of Persia and kind of take a twist on it. And that would, you know, would be a really fun project to work on for the students. So I think the really good student should have a good understanding of idea creation. He should have good understanding in design and also solid fundamentals. And I think the most important part is that he should love movies and games. And, you know, that will bring out the best in him. That will bring out all the hard work, that will bring out the love, and that will bring out, you know, what he will bring to the entertainment industry, which is his own IPs, his own creations, and he will go ahead and make awesome games. You know, that's the whole idea. I think the difference here at FX School is that we actually teach them to be really fast-paced, because the industry, it does not wait for you. You know, it's really fast and it's really demanding. So what happens is they want ideas quickly and they want ideas to be generated really fast. So even here we worked in a project basis where we give the student a project to work on like he would be working in the industry. So that's the difference between, you know, just learning things and actually experiencing, you know, working in a project. The best part about this course is that, you know, once you understand the fundamentals and once your creative juice start flowing, then your ideas, you know, you can keep putting them down and you can show it to different people and pitch them to different companies. And, you know, some company would totally pick your idea up and, you know, your next mobile game would be yours. So you never know, and you could be the next Angry Birds or you could be the next Clash of Clans. And, you know, that's a really good, awesome thing.